you guys were great. We love Sid. We listen every morning.
So, so let me ask you this. So there's no black kids in this.
No, of course not.
What's going on? Right. No Latinos?
Back then, there was in my class.
There was, I had a couple of black kids in my class. We actually had a really good running back when I was there. Barry Watkins, I think, was his name.
He left.
He was all city. He was a tremendous player. But so a Poly Prep really does love me. And
they totally love you. Okay, they're waiting for you to come back.
Well, how about getting my daughter Ava in without charging us an arm and a leg? Don't I get that, like, legend status? Like
legacy.
Thank you. Yeah. Like John Franco and Steve Sirippa get?
Like when the police officers pull you over and they know, oh, you're
right,
sitting
right. Right.
So, yeah, but they still give you a ticket, right? Like a broken speedometer or something. So, Polly, instead of charging you an arm and a leg, maybe they'll only take, like, an arm. You can have the leg. We'll let you keep your leg, but, you know, the arm, we need the arm.
You know what's funny, Bern, is I'm the quote-unquote famous radio host, all that stuff. If I went into Poly today, I'll give you three guys, Bernie. It's me, it's Arthur, who's very famous on Fox News, on TV all the time.
I'm famous. It's my mother.
You're famous. and who's my boy again from the other car dealers? Robbie Sabah.
Oh, he's fantastic.
He owns the place. If I walk in...
He owns Poly Prep.
Right, so the three of us, I get the least amount of help. The least amount of help.
Well, I don't think it's a secret. Did you actually? I didn't see there was a picture in the yearbook from when you graduated, right?
No, I left.
Oh, right.
I was there for 5 years. I took $30,000. My grades sucked. I was betting on football with every mobster's kid across Bay Ridge. So I went to Yeshiva.
How'd that work out for you? How'd the yeshiva work out for you?
It
was
fine.
Wait, when did you leave? You left in 11th grade?
10th grade.
10th grade. Yeah. So you missed 11th. You missed a couple of good years.
I did miss some good years. No, and I still love a lot of those guys. And I love the school.
That's a problem.
It's interesting. I was liking listening to your police officer pullover stories. Because we've all been there, no matter who you are. Like, even when you're a cop and you get pulled over.
Yeah.
You still get the butterflies.
No doubt about
it. Like, my police officer friends are like, yeah, when you hear the siren, yeah. Because you never... No, you never. And I'll tell you where they're the worst is Staten Island. My cousin was a Highway 5. So it goes Highway 1 is New York. Highway 2 is Brooklyn. Right. And 3 is the Bronx. 4 is Queens. And 5 is Staten Island. Staten Island, those cops, the highway cops, were giving police officers tickets. They were giving police officers wives.
They're the worst. They wear the old Gestapo boots 100%. And whatnot. And they're really intimidating. And even the state troopers, too, they're also very tough, very aggressive.
The number one
aggressive.
Rule is make sure they see your hands when they approach the car.
That's what I was
definitely
saying.
Definitely put their mind at ease.
Do not look for your license and registration.
Just put your hands right there and say, you know, then when they come over and say, officer, can I reach in my pocket and get my license and registration? While you're doing that, they're scanning the whole car. Is there a gun? Does it smell like weed? Is it there drugs? Do I see what? You know, what do I see? What can I see?
That was the worst. Is back in the day when, I used to indulge. You had a little bit of that stuff in the glove compartment or whatever, anywhere on your person. That's when you really got nervous.
100%. Nowadays.
Now I feel good. I feel, somebody said it the other day, like liberated. You know, I get pulled over, and I'm not worried in the least about something like that.
Oh, I thought you meant now that if you continue to smoke grass, like they pull you over, because it's basically almost legal.
Yeah,
I mean, I was walking through the village last night.
Yeah.
Sid, I went out with my friend Shep Smith last night, and we're walking through, you know, I got solicited. It was like 1985 all over again.
For pot.
I got smed. I got coke. I got coke. I got coke. Yeah. I got smoke. I got weed. I got something.
Now, was this Washington Square Park?
Yeah, and I'm wearing a suit. Like, I could have easily, I'm with a tie. I mean, I could be a cop or something.
It's anything goes now.
They don't care. Good I got part. Weed. I got coke. I got coke. I got weed. I'm like, okay.
Well, the rest of the story, you obviously didn't buy, but Shep Smith put a whole bunch of stuff, didn't he?
Oh, yeah. Mr. Seltzer.
A couple of dime bags.
Mr. Seltzer with a lime in it.
I like Shep. But Bernie hates him, but I like him.
I don't hate him. But listen, the question that we had. We played this audio tape.
I'm glad you always correct yourself.
Those guys getting pulled over. Are you allowed to videotape the cop, attorney Arthur Idala?
I mean, there's no law.
While they pull you over. He said, the cop's contention was you're under lawful detention, so you're not allowed to use your cell phone.
I don't know the actual legal answer to that question. Right. I can tell you there is no rule in the penal law that says you can't do it. Yeah, it's actually a word, yeah. Sydney. Yeah, there's no rule there that says you can't do it. But I could see while you're under the lawful detention, let's face it, we are under arrest, right? At that period of time,
right.
Arrest means your liberty is taken away. You can't, a guy, cop pulls you over. You can't just get out of the car and walk away.
No.
Say, no, 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 right. I don't want to talk to you. I want to go to the bathroom. You can't do that. No. You are That happened to me once. I was dying. I was speeding because I had to go to the bathroom. And I'm like, officer, you can write me the ticket. Can I just go into the 7-Eleven and take a pee? Right. And he was just like, absolutely not. Stay where you are.
Oh, boy.
And it was not a comfortable situation. But, yeah, they have a lot of control in those moments. And it's all, and Bernie, you'll appreciate it, it's all about their protection. It's all about, because the cop doesn't know what he's about to encounter.
Right, right.
He doesn't know if it's a little old lady who's harmless or if it's some guy with a Tech 9 semi-automatic.
Yeah, yeah. It's got to be terrifying every time he pulls somebody over.
Of course. We got a break. Stick around for one more segment. But absolutely. One quick story on the way out. I got a ticket for the silliest thing ever. And you'll love this story. TJ Bentley's.
Oh, sure. 73rd and 3rd Avenue. Bay Ridge, Brooklyn. That was a legendary spot for a long time.
A lot of us went to Captain Walter's in Cheapside Bay and Emmons Avenue on Thursday nights.
Everyone got in trouble there.
Right, that was a Thursday night. Either Captain Walter's,
Hobnails,
or TJ Bentley. I've got a story leaving TJ Bentley with Danielle.
I got a castle in Brooklyn. That's where I'm from, Brass Monkey.
And where I got pulled over. We'll get to that with Arthur Idala right after these words.
That man sitting on a little stool takes a money from my hand while his eyes take a walk all over.
So we're leaving TJ Bentley's on a Thursday night, right? We've had a couple of drinks. It was before we're married. We're still dating. Just like the story about the cop in Golden Beach. And we used to go out on Thursday nights and drink a lot, my wife and I. A lot. So we leave TJ Bentley's and there's a light.
Just give me a year.
I want to say it was 1991.
I was going to say
in my rear view mirror is the MF in law.
1991. So we're sitting at a red light, maybe two blocks away from TJ Bentley's. And we kiss, you know. And we're still kissing. So I don't know. Must have gone through. The light must have turned red. Must have turned green. Must have turned red. Must have turned green. Maybe five times. And we're just going at it, you know.
And just so your listeners know, Sid and Danielle still do that to this day.
100%.
Right.
And the next thing you know, I see the lights behind
me. Whoop. It's the worst sound. Whoop.
They pull me over. And
as they should.
I guess. I'm like, what?
Get out of the way.
Yeah, we got a ticket for, it wasn't even public lewdness. It was, we caused a traffic jam, which was like four cars, by the way, in Bay Ridge. But we sat through three or four lights. The cop was furious.
A hell of a makeout session.
It really? Was good. Well, I was in my 20s. I was very good. I mean, that's
your big TJ Bentley story?
Yes. You're talking about getting pulled over by the cops for silly stuff. Kissing by a light is not a silly reason somebody over?
My junior year of poly prep, I went into my parents' garage with my three best buddies.
Oh, boy.
Luckily, we put the case of beer and anything else in the trunk of the car. I did not have a driver's license, Bernie. I didn't have a license.
Well, you were driving?
I didn't even have a learner's permit. I take my dad's car. He's got a four-door sedan, Alfa Romeo Alfetta, and I'm zipping down Narrows Avenue. I don't know where I'm heading, the 69th Street Pier, and I blow right through a stop sign,
uh-oh.
And the cop is right there. And here is the difference between today's police and the police in 1983-84. Just pulls me out of the car by my collar, buddy. He can tell I'm too young to be driving. Calls me an AH. I think Sid says that on the air, but I don't use that word. Yeah, right. And basically, literally, Bernie kicks me in the butt. He literally, kicks me in the butt.
Wow. Yeah,
I am just apologizing. I go, look, you could drive my car home, and your partner can follow. And he just looks at me, and he goes, if I give you a ticket now, you won't get your driver's license till you're 21. Now, when you're 16, 15 and a half, that's like eternity, right? I mean, I'm not getting my license for another.
So he's doing you a favor. He's teaching you a lesson.
He tells me to get in the car. This is insane. Tells me to get in the car, drive it home, and he goes, Arthur, I better never see you again. And he lets me drive the car.
Let you drive it home.
Back home without a license.
Wow.
I literally.
A lot of cops are cool.
I drove the car back home. I put it in the garage, opened the trunk, got out the beer, closed the trunk. And Bernie, I swear on my children, I got on my hands and knees and I kissed the floor outside my parents' garage. And I was thrilled. That would never, ever happen.
It shouldn't happen then. You can't drive without a license.
A cop would have left. The difference is this.
A cop
today would lock up that
16-year-old kid. You get arrested. I was just going
to
say,
you're going to jail.
So now a 16-year-old kid is going in front of a judge, and he's experienced the criminal justice system. He's experiencing what it feels like to have handcuffs on him.
Yeah.
You know, it's just a different world.
You know, you used to drive around Bainbridge without a license and drive a
Cadillac.
No, not a Cadillac. A Jaguar.
Oh.
His family owned one of the more popular Italian restaurants on the West Side Highway.
Oh, Ponti.
Vinny Ponti, yeah.
There you go. He's like Bay Ridge trivia.
Like 16 years old driving a Jaguar around, you know, Shore Boulevard.
Hey, listen, I remember when my father was driving around when we were kids. He'd have a cooler full of beer in the car.
Oh,
and
God
a
bless.
Can between his legs, for God's sake. I swear to God.
How old were you when you got your first car?
I was...
Well, you lived in Long Island.
I was different. I was in my late 20s. I was poor. I put myself through college. I was a street kid. And so
I was 22.
Took a long time.
But I was 22. Yeah, but, you know, and that was only because I was in school upstate. So if you didn't have a car, you really was stuck. But in New York, I never knew what DWI was. You walked up the block, there was the bar, you drank too much, and you walked home. I never drove.
No, listen, I did the same. I drove a taxi at night and put myself through college. And on Friday nights and Saturday nights, when all the kids were out partying at the bars, I was working, driving a cab. But around 9, 10 o'clock, I'd get a six-pack, and I would start partying myself as I drove the cab
all
night
long.
And I wasn't in fear of the cops.
No.
This is in the 80s.
Would you say you worked harder in school and took it more seriously because you paid for it?
Absolutely. I was an A student. I got scholarships. I was tutoring other kids, statistics and English literature, stuff like that.
Totally agree.
No doubt about it. And the fact that I waited a few years, not intentionally, just inadvertently, didn't go for a few years, I appreciated it immensely more than I would have had I gone at 18 years old.
I'm 51 years old. That is one of the biggest lessons I've learned, not just about education, about anything. When you earn it yourself, when you work for it yourself, you care and take care of it more than...
No doubt.
And you want to talk about cars? It's the same thing. My first car was $400. They listed it in the school for $500. I told my dad about it. He goes, I'll give you $400. You're on your own for the rest. Mm. And I went in. I negotiated. I think I got the woman. It was a girl, like a classmate. I got it down to like $435. I would... shine it. It was a rust bucket. It was a piece of garbage.
But it was yours.
But for me, it was heavy. Yeah. But these kids today, you hand them the keys to a Lexus. Oh, yeah, here's a $52,000 car. Be careful. Be careful, sweetie. Pay attention to the speed limit.
What was your car? Remember, what kind of was it?
The first car?
A Pinto.
A punch buggy.
The only reason why my father bought it for me, allowed me to buy it, was because it was Italian. It was a $400 Alfa Romeo sedan.
Hilarious.
It had rust all the way around. And the backseat, my buddy Joe Hassan, who left us on September 11th.
I love it, Joe.
He goes, you know, I love this car. He goes, there's a hole right through the floorboard. He goes, we could be drinking and pee right through it. You don't even have to stop.
Oh, boy.
Talk about the days.
Yeah, those were the days.
That's right. Yeah, the ladies bobbing for apples.
There was no videotape to videotape a cop when he pulled you over. It didn't exist.
No, not
we had a better world, better life.
It was a better life, right?
Oh, tough.
Are
those
you kidding me?
Were the days,
yeah,
my
baby.
Friends. It no, was... Archie, do Archie. Those were the days.
Oh, Archie, my friend.
Well, Artie, as always, you're an unbelievable guy.
Friday, baby.
Great. Right.
Big
it's
weekend.
Such a great guest.
Big weekend.
Yes.
Yeah, so Mother's Day, baby.
To your mother, happy Mother's Day.
I got my wife a very special present.
What you
got? My wife, I got a very special present. My mother's present is she's in Krakow, Poland right now with my father at 81 and 78 visiting friends. I mean, that's spectacular.
That's beautiful. Oh, what about your wife? What do you do for your wife?
I got her a very, very special present, and I don't know if she's listening, so I'll tell you next time.
Is it the
it's
best?
Very cool. I'll tell you guys when we get off that.
Is it the best of Bernie and Sid CD?
It's something that she does not have. close. A close second. You guys are the best. Keep having fun.
You're the best. We love you. Artie Adonis, everybody.
ABC.
Back on Bernie and Sid right after this.